going to be looking to the right. We're going to see once again from another angle what our two explorers would have endured as they were crawling through this part of the cave. Now, these two gentlemen were about 6 feet tall. And as you can clearly see, they had some small and very narrow spaces to go through. Now, they did not even have all the protective gear either. They had to use old t-shirts and pieces of cloth wrapped around their hands and knees to protect themselves from crawling through this very, very rough terrain. Now, the stream that we're seeing on our right, coming from the Rosh Mahalkali, it does not end here by the village. During the 5.5 years of developing this cave, at certain points, they actually had to reroute the water. Now, this stream, it comes by the village where it goes under the road, and then continues into this hole we see over here on our right. Now, we will see this stream again in a little bit, but for now, ladies and gentlemen, we will be traveling to the left. For our next stop, we will be looking at the original entrance into the cave system. Now, it took our explorers approximately 4.5 hours from the surface, and during that time, they were surrounded by bats, frogs, cricket, spiders, centipedes, millipedes, mice, snakes, you name it. So as you can only imagine, by the time they reached this ledge over here, they would have been hot and tired. So they did what anyone else would have done at that point. They jumped in the pool. Took a swim. Had to cool off somehow, right? Now after swimming around in that water, which has a depth of 9 feet at its center, 9 feet deep, after swimming around, they eventually discovered this stream of water on our right, leading away from that pool. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please keep in mind, this area that we're traveling under, this is all solid rock. This was a man-made tunnel. Now, they dug out these tunnels parallel to the original pathways, allowing us a first-hand look of what these explorers would have endured. Now, they would have been following this exact same stream right here. And as it took them further deeper into the cave system, when they came out on the other end, that is where they made a discovery. They found a room with a second stream of water. Now, the first stream would be coming from the Harris Gully that we just followed. And this is where they discovered that second stream from the Welch Mahal Gully, right over here. Now, this is the same stream that went under the road by the village and into that dark hole. They would have crawled through this opening, and that would have led them to the rotunda room where we just came from. Now, this area, ladies and gentlemen, is known as Twin Falls, okay? Twin Falls. Now, at this time, I need you to hold on to your helmets as we look above our heads at the roof. Here we will see hundreds, if not thousands, of baby stalactites. Now, at this stage of growth, we call them solar straws, as they are hollow at the center. Now, keep in mind, it takes 1 year for them to grow the thickness of a piece of paper. A very slow process. But once you have seen the little ones, it really allows us to fully appreciate the adults, bringing us to our second view of the Great Hall, the largest room in this cave system. Now, the Great Hall, with a height of 100 feet, it is actually said a five-story building to fit in this cave. But I have to let you guys know, the Great Hall actually goes by another name. Some people call this the Cathedral. If you use your imagination, you will see what looks like a bishop at the top. We will have a congregation. And if you look over your right shoulder all the way to the back, you will see what looks like a pipe organ. Now, as you're looking back, ladies and gentlemen, you notice this dark space right up here? Now, that's where we would have first stopped when we entered the cave just a few minutes ago. That was our first look into this cave system. Now, from here, ladies and gentlemen, we will be traveling through the Great Hall and entering the Snake Tunnel. As a reminder, if you're sitting on the edge, please make sure your hands and legs are nice and neatly tucked in. No standing in this part of the cave, as the roof is a little lower than whatsoever. No touching of the walls or formations are allowed. Now, when the engineers came to this tunnel, they actually wanted to keep the original roof intact. So what they would have done to create space, they dug through the floors. Now, if you look around the walls, we're going to see a line. This is where the floor was when this tunnel was first discovered. All along here, this was the original floor line. Now, the further we go into the tunnel, we will start to notice some white formations growing on the walls around us. These formations are called flowstone. Now, the flowstone formations are formed when a constant flow of water trickles down on the surface, leaving behind the calcium carbonate which charges, creating this beautiful white-like substance. Now, one of my co-workers has convinced that this white stuff looks like ice or snow. Did I see it? Yeah. Now, I want you guys to look above my head. We're going to see another formation. Can anyone tell me what does it look like? What does it resemble? Remember, use your imagination. Let me know what you see. Any guesses? What does it look like to you? A desk, yes. Does anyone see a piece of cloth hanging over a ledge? Now, we have actually made this piece right here, ladies and gentlemen, the drapery. That simple fact, it looks like a cloth, a towel, a tablecloth, a sheet even hanging over the edge. Now, as we continue, we will be looking at one of our guys, and since the cave was open, we have actually had proposals done on that spot. Now, usually the gentleman will give a wink or a nod, give us a little sign, we'll stop the tram and allow him to do his magic. And we are very proud to say that we haven't received any no's, okay? They've all been successful. Now, as we continue, we're going to notice a body of water on our left. This is called Mirror Lake. Now, Mirror Lake stretches for 15 meters or 50 feet in a semi-circle or U-shape, and will be one of the beautiful sights you will see in this cave today. Mirror Lake has a depth of 2 to 4 feet at its deepest point. And ladies and gentlemen, this is a collection of filtered water. Now, this water went through that 6 to 9 month process of dripping through the limestone rock. Now, as we look at Mirror Lake, we will notice there's a white substance underneath the water. That white stuff is called calcite. It is a mineral deposit left back from the water after it has been filtered. Now, that calcite that we're looking at, as beautiful as it is actually very, very dangerous. For the simple fact that it can mimic quicksand. And right around that bend, it has a depth of 6 to 8 feet. So please trust me, if you walk through that water, the only thing you will probably ever find will be your helmets. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you ask me, I'll tell you that is a very good reason why you never go caving or exploring by yourselves. Now, at this time, we're going to do a little experiment. We are going to embrace the natural lighting of this cave. So I need you to lock your phones, turn off your cameras. We're going to stop all devices from emitting any type of light. And once you've done that, I'm going to ask you to close your eyes nice and tight. So eyes closed. Now those with the little ones, let them know it will get dark, okay? And only open your eyes when I tell you to, okay? All right. Yeah, sure.
Open your eyes.
Whoa!
Now, ladies and gentlemen, you cannot see your hands in front of your face, nor can you see the person sitting directly next to you. However, if you're very quiet, you will hear the sound of the water up ahead. You guys hear it? Now, our two explorers would have lost the light at certain points, and the sound of the water was what they had to use to navigate out of this cave system. But, ladies and gentlemen, luckily for us today, we have lights. Ta-da!
A slight delay, but it works. Slight delay. Now hold on to your helmets, ladies and gentlemen, as we continue marveling at this beautiful bedrock roof above our heads, while we follow the stream of water on our left. Now this stream will lead us to a pool we call Cascade Pool. We which has a depth of 5 to 9 feet, and is to this point with a waterfall that flows 365 days a year. Now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is the Fountain of Youth. So while we are here, you have the opportunity where you can walk underneath the waterfall. You can stick your hand out, touch the water, splash yourselves if you choose to. As a reminder, ladies and gentlemen, please do not touch the walls or formations within this area. And there's absolutely